This is a total solar eclipse, and humans have been observing it for a very long time in our history. But somewhat about 500 million years from now, there won't be any total solar eclipse. And this is because the moon is drifting away from Earth. Yes, our moon is drifting away from us at a rate of 3.8 centimeter per year. Right now, the moon has a perfect size and is at a perfect distance to cover the sun and cause a total solar eclipse. But as the moon will drift away, it won't be able to cover the whole sun and there won't be a total solar eclipse. The moon is sufficiently large and is sufficiently close to raise tides on Earth. So you're looking at the Earth and the moon system. The moon causes tides on the side it faces and the opposite side of the Earth due to its gravitational pull. And how does it do that? If you want to learn more about it, pause this video, click the annotation on the screen or the first link in the description box below. This video will resume in 3, 2, 1, yeah. The tidal bulge should be exactly below the moon, but this is not the case. The Earth's rotational motion drags the position of the tidal bulge ahead of the position directly under the moon. The bulge itself has mass and therefore a little extra gravity. If the bulge was exactly under the moon would orbit normally. But this offset causes a change in the gravitational pull from the Earth. So the bulge that's closer to the moon causes a stronger gravitational pull as compared to the bulge that's further away. This tiny gravitational difference causes a tiny pull in the direction of the moon's orbit. This push speeds up the moon, causing it to move to a higher orbit. So this is why the moon is drifting away from us. The Earth itself is helping it to speed up, and in turn, Earth is slowing down. If there was no friction, the moon's gravitational force on the tidal bulge would rapidly bring the tides back in synchronization with the moon just within 2 days, and the moon would no longer recede from us. Such a scenario already exists in our solar system, in the Pluto and Charon system. This was it for today. Please do like, share, subscribe to my channel for all the future video. You can click the subscribe button that's above me or the link in the description. To watch my previous video, click on the thumbnails. And as always, stay curious, stay awesome.